Now, let us see about the wind currents due to uneven heating of the earth. First of all, we need to understand the meaning of uneven heating of the earth. It means what? If we see the structure of the earth, in between we have the equator, then we have the, at the edges, we have the north and south pole. So when the sun rays fall on the earth, so they fall, they do not fall evenly, but how they fall is unevenly. So based upon these two situations, the first one is regarding uneven heating between the equator and poles causes the north-south winds. Second is uneven heating of land and water causes monsoon winds on earth, which brings rainfall. Let us see in detail about uneven heating between the equator and poles causes the north-south winds. We know that the earth is divided into circular lines called latitudes that specify the north-south position of a place on the globe. Also, the equator is latitude that is perpendicular to the axis of the earth's rotation. The regions that are close to the equator receive maximum sunlight on the earth. Hence, the air in these regions is generally warm. The warm air therefore rises above and the cold air from the latitude around the equator moves in that place. Similarly, cold winds from north and south poles move towards the equator and the neighboring latitude, and the circulation of winds takes place on the earth. So this is how we can see about the wind flow pattern because of uneven heating on the earth. At the edges, what we have is the north and the south pole. In between, we have the equator. Second situation is uneven heating of land and water causes monsoon winds on earth, which brings rainfall. In the summer season, the land near the equator gets warmer and its temperature generally remains higher than the oceans. As a result, what are above the land rises and the cold air from the oceans moves towards the land. These winds are called monsoon winds. Since these winds come from the ocean, they carry water. In a similar way, the winds in the winter season move from the land towards the ocean. So here we can see regarding the air moving from the ocean towards the land, which bring the monsoon rains.